A library acts as a container for presets, stored in the file format XRNL, which is easily installed via drag and drop. Once installed, the library's contents will be available to use through the preset menus, effect devices, and themes. Since a library's contents can be many different things, the installer will helpfully tell you what was installed, whether it was a bunch of new instruments, some multi-sample presets, or perhaps a collection of effect chains. If you save one of your own presets, it's stored in a special location, the user library, which is found in the same folder as any installed libraries. And since this is shared for Renoise and Redux, any preset from one can also be used in the other. Instruments are constructed from a variety of parts: phrases, key zones, waveform, modulation, and effects. Specific preset types for each of these sections are available from a drop-down menu at the top right corner, where you can load, save, import, and export. This allows an existing instrument to load the various presets into their specific sections, without overwriting the whole instrument. A library can contain any of the file types associated with these sections, as well as two others. Phrase presets can be one of two types. A pattern phrase is an XML file describing the number of lines, columns, and other settings, such as loop tempo, etc., that make up a single phrase. For phrase scripts, this is simply the Lua script file. Key zones use the open source format of SFZ to store both the key zones data and all of an instrument's samples. This provides access to a huge resource, since SFZ files created in external sources can be imported, and the popular sound font format SF2 can be easily converted into SFZ. Watch the Key Zones video for more details. In contrast to the Key Zones, a waveform preset is just an individual sample saved as a FLAC file. A modulation set preset is an XML file of the modulation envelopes built within the various sample domains, volume, panning, etc. Check out the sampler modulation video to learn exactly how this works. An effect chain preset is an XML file of the effect devices and parameter values that make up an effect chain. And note that although the preset menu is for instruments, the effect chains are compatible with track effects. An effect device preset is an XML file that defines the parameters of a single effect device. This can be any of the singular devices or particular combinations contained within a doofer or splitter. And finally are the XML files used for themes, which are alternative visual styles for the interface. The Themes tab of the Preferences menu is where existing ones can be selected and new ones created. If you're a registered user of Renoise or Redux, you have access to a few official libraries via the backstage area of the Renoise website. But it's also possible to create your own libraries to distribute to other people. There are full instructions for this process in the online user manual. Link in the video description or below wherever this has been posted.